Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to give this GTA effect to your photos in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then smash that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the model image which I'll be using in order to create a GTA effect. So the first step over here we need to do is separate out the model from the background. Now you can do that using quick selection tool, or else you can do that using pen tool as well. Now I will be choosing pen tool over here, since we need to add that black stroke surrounding the model, and a stroke will look better if we cut out the model using the selection made using pen tool. So for that, select pen tool and then using pen tool make the path of the model as follows. Now make sure you create a path which is little bit inside so that you don't get any color from the background. Now once your path is ready, after that right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. After that set the feather radius as 0 and then click on OK. After that press Ctrl plus J which will create a duplicate of the image which is inside of the selection into a new layer. After that, hide the background layer by clicking on the eye icon and then make the background layer active by clicking on it. After that, let's fill the background with white color for now. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option solid color. After that, set the color as white and then click on OK. After that, make the duplicate model image layer active by clicking on it and then right click on the layer and then select option convert to smart object. After that, as you can see, there is a bit darkness on the model, so let's brighten it up. So for that, go to image and then adjustments and then select option shadows and highlights. After that, set the shadows and highlights as default and then click on OK. Now after that, we need to give this model image a little bit of cartoon effect. So for that, go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option posture edges. After that, set the edge thickness as 0, edge intensity as 1, and then set the posterization according to the comic cartoon effect you want over here. I will be setting it as 3 and then click on OK. Now after that, double click on the filter gallery blending options icon and then reduce the opacity of the filter to 50% and then click on OK. Now after that, let's smooth out the overall image and give some oil painting effect over here. So for that, go to filter and then select option oil paint. After that, set the stylization as 2, cleanliness as 10, scale as 0.1, bristle detail as 0, angular direction as 0 and shine as 0. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, we have smoothed out the overall image, but as you can see there is some noise in the image. So for that, go to filter and then noise and then select option reduce noise. After that, set the strength as 10 and then the rest of the option as 0 and then click on OK. Now after that, let's sharpen the overall image and add some contrast over here as well. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen and then select option unsharp mask. After that, set the amount as 80%, radius as 4 pixels and threshold as 0 levels. To show you the effect of this unsharp mask, clicking on this preview checkbox. After that, again clicking it. So as you can see, by adding this unsharp mask filter, it sharpens the overall image and adds some contrast to the image. After that, click on OK. Now after that, we need to smooth out the skin in order to make it look like a cartoon effect. So for that, go to filter and then blur and then select option surface blur. After that, set the radius as 10 pixels, threshold as 10. Now to show you the effect of this surface blur filter, clicking on this preview checkbox. After that, again checking it. So as you can see, by adding the surface blur filter, it smooths out the skin. After that, you click on OK. Now after that, let's add our final filter in order to complete the cartoon effect. So for that, go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option cutout. After that, set the number of levels as 6, edge simplicity as 4 and edge fidelity as 2 and then click on OK. Now after that, double click on the filter blending options icon. After that, set the blend mode of the filter to soft light and then reduce its opacity to 60%. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, we have added the cartoon effect to the models over here. Now let's add strokes surrounding the model. So for that, click on add layer style icon and then select option blending options. After that, select the stroke option and then set the size of the stroke as 10 pixels. Set the position as outside, blend mode as normal and color as black. After that, click on OK. Now our model is ready. Now after that, we need to add background over here in order to make it look like a GTA effect. So for that, go to file and then select option place. After that, select any nice background which might look like a GTA background. After that, click on place. After that, scale this image so that it fits properly. Press shift while scaling to scale evenly. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now after that, drag this background layer below the model layer. Now after that, we need to add this cartoon effect to the background over here as well. So for that, what we can do is copy the filters layer from the model layer and then paste it in the background layer. So for that, press Alt and then drag the smart filter layer and then paste it over here. So as you can see, the filters has been applied to the background over here as well, but I would like to edit some of the filters in order to make it look more better. So for that, click on this drop down to expand the filters. After that, double click on the first filter gallery option in order to edit it. After that, click on OK. Now after that, let's reduce the posterization over here to 0. After that, click on OK. After that, double click on that filter gallery blending options icon and then click on OK. And then increase the opacity of that filter to 100%. After that, click on OK. Now the next thing I would like to edit is this unsharp mask filter. So for that, double click on that. Now over here, I would like to increase the amount to 110%. And then click on OK. And the next filter I would like to edit is this cutout filter. So for that, double click on this filter gallery options. And then increase the number of levels over here to 8. So now as you can see, by changing just some of the filters, the background image is also looking so good. But as you can see, our model image is not blending properly with the background image. So for that, make the model image layer active by clicking on it. After that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option curves. After that, by default, the mask of the curves layer will be active. Now in order to make the curves layer active, click on this icon over here. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then press Alt and then click on this auto option. After that, select the option find dark and light colors and then set the color of the shadows, midtones and highlights from the background image over here. After that, click on OK. After that, minimize it and then change the blend mode of this curves layer to color. And then reduce its opacity to 40%. So now as you can see, the model image is blending somewhat with the background over here. Now let's add that text logo of that GTA over here. So for that, click on this file and then select option place. Download link for this PNG text image is in the description below. After that, click on this place. After that, scale that text and place it properly. Press shift while scaling to scale evenly. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now let's do one more thing so that the model image completely blends with the background. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option gradient map. After that, select the gradient as violet and orange and then minimize it. After that, set the blend mode of this layer to soft light and then reduce its opacity to 40%. So now as you can see, our model image now completely blends with the background. Now let's add one more filter in order to give this GTA effect a better look. So for that, press Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt plus E, which will merge all the visible layers into a single layer. After that, go to Filter and then select option Filter Gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option Fresco. After that, set the size of the brush as 2. Brush detail as 8 and texture as 1. After that, click on OK. and then reduce the opacity of this layer to 50%. To show you the effect of this fresco filter, clicking on this eye icon. So as you can see, by adding this filter, it gives such a nice look. So that's it guys, this will give you your GTA effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos. And subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.